We are already in the month of May. Can you all believe that? We are in the fifth month of the year. It's already May. Oh my goodness. Well, you all know that I like to get things started with a poem. So I want to read a poem for us about the month of May. The Month of May by Thomas Decker. Oh, the month of May, the merry month of May, so long awaited and so quickly passed. The winter's over and it's time to play. I saw 100 shades of green today, and everything that man made was outclassed. Oh, the month of May, the merry month of May. Now, hello, pink and white, and farewell, gray. My spirits are no longer overcast. The winter's over and it's time to play. In the month of May, the merry month of May. So carpe diem, gather buds and make hay. The world is glorious. Compare, contrast December with the merry month of May. Now is the time. Now is the time to play in the merry month of May. And here we are on a Monday afternoon in the month of May and in the season of spring. You know, we still think of the season of spring when we're in the month of May, don't we? So we're going to talk about that today. We're going to talk about the season of May, and we're going to talk about May, springtime, Monday. Well, you know, when I come, I like for us to think about the month that we're in. So I want to tell you a little bit about what all happens during the month of May. Some fun events and holidays, things to know. You know, from early on, our fifth month, the merry month of May, it's been associated with dancing and singing, love, and general rejoicing that spring has returned after a long and dreary winter. Shakespeare said this. He once described someone as full of spirit as the month of May. Do you, any of you all ever feel that way, full of spirit as the month of May? Well, another poet, Louise Moulton, said this, the month it was, the month of May, and all the flowers sprang up to see. And we're going to talk about flowers in a little while. We always think of flowers in springtime, don't we? Well, what about events and holidays? Let's think about some things that happen in this month of May. How about the very first day of May, May Day? Anybody ever heard of May Day or maybe participated in a May Day? It's always celebrated the first day of May and marked with all kinds of celebrations. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate these. Thank you. Beautiful bookmarks. Welcoming the return of spring. Oh, there are all kinds of traditions associated with May Day. How about creating little baskets full of sweets and flowers, singing and dancing around a maypole? Now, did anybody ever do a maypole dance growing up, maybe in school? That used to be very popular. And in some schools, elementary children's schools, they still have maypoles and dance around the maypole even now on the first of day. Spring flowers are picked and gifted to loved ones. And although maybe we don't hear of it as much as we used to, people all over the world still celebrate May Day. Okay, here's another holiday in May. last week we celebrated Cinco de Mayo. Now, does anybody remember celebrating Cinco de Mayo? Cinco de Mayo is Spanish for the 5th of May. It's a day that's observed in Mexico and here in the United States on May the 5th. And it's when the Mexican army defeated the French army at the Battle of Pueblo. May the 5th, 1862, and we still celebrate it today. Culture, achievements of those of Mexican origin. Businesses promote Mexican food and drinks and music. Do any of you all like Mexican food? Anybody here enjoy maybe tacos or burritos or taco salad? How about salsa? Salsa and chips, does that sound good? I love Mexican food. Well, yesterday we celebrated a very important holiday. We celebrated Mother's Day. Did you all celebrate Mother's Day yesterday? We did. We celebrated with my mom for sure. It was established the second Sunday in May, and in 1914, President Woodrow Wilson passed a law to make Mother's Day a national holiday. And I think that's a wonderful thing, don't you all? I think it's important for us to honor and remember our mothers. And next month, we have Father's Day. Well, there's one other holiday that's really important this month, the month of May, and that's Memorial Day. At the end of the month, the last Monday in May serves, very importantly, it's a time that we honor and remember all of the men and women who've served in the military. It's a 3-day weekend. Some people say that Memorial Day kicks off summer. We go to the beach, we start our vacations, we have barbecues and picnics. And did you all know that towns and cities all over the United States, they have Memorial Day parades? And a lot of veterans and military personnel join in. It is a celebration, and Memorial Day is just about 3 weeks away from today. Well, what else happens in May? Did you all know that May is National Tap Dancing Month? Now, did any of you all in here tap dance? Anybody tap dance? No, me either, but I like to listen to it. I like to watch and listen to tap dance. Did you know that May is National Smile Month? That means everybody has to smile once a day in May. I'm looking for some smiles. May is National Smile Day. That's what I like to see. Yes, indeed. May is National Egg Month. Anybody in here like eggs? I love deviled eggs. Anybody in here like deviled eggs? Nothing better. How about Older American Month? And that's all of us, isn't it? May is full of all kinds of very important, very, very special times. Well, let's think a little bit more about May and talk just a few minutes. This is a picture of an emerald. And a beautiful green emerald stone. It represents love and success, and it is the birthstone for the month of May. It was one of Cleopatra's favorite gems and long been associated with rebirth and love. Ancient Romans went so far as to dedicate this stone to Venus, the goddess of love and beauty. And today, it is thought that the emerald signifies wisdom, growth, and patience. So the emerald is the birthstone for May, which means we have to think about birthdays in May. Some very famous people who have birthdays in May are President Harry Truman, President John F. Kennedy, Queen Victoria, the great comedian Bob Hope, His birthday is in May. How about the musical composer Irving Berlin and the famous nurse Florence Nightingale? Now, the most important question is, do any of you all have a birthday in May? Is anybody born in May? Well, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Your birthstone is the emerald, and your flower is the lily of the valley, also referred to as Our Lady's Tears, the May Lily, May Bells. And you know, it's not actually a lily. It is a member of the asparagus family. Had you ever heard that before? Oh my goodness. Well, it produces, you know, beautiful white, bell-shaped white flowers with a very strong, sweet smell. Did any of you all ever have Lily of the Valley in your yards, maybe, or in your flower gardens? They're very petite, aren't they? But very, very pretty. They can also come in pink and purple blossoms as well. They have been associated with motherhood, sweetness, purity, and humility. A return to spring and happiness. Now, sometimes I will bring a little picture of the birth flower of the month, and here's the one for May, the Lily of the Valley. And I want to read you the poem that's with it. Welcoming May's butterflies are lazy bells and blushing skies. With smiles and laughter, charm and grace, your love, May birthday, feels like a warm embrace. How about that? So, I like May, and I like learning a little bit about the month of May on this Monday afternoon in the month of May and in the season of spring. Well, you know, I said that another holiday we have is Mother's Day, and we just celebrated that yesterday. Lori, did you have a good Mother's Day?
I did. Yes,
good. I did. Well, I'm glad. I'm glad to hear that. So I thought we'd play a little game this afternoon. I want to test and see how much you know about Mother's Day. We're going to play a little trivia game, okay? The modern Mother's Day holiday was celebrated in which country? Was it celebrated first in Germany, the United States, or France? Who wants to take a guess? Somebody says France. Okay, anybody else? Anybody else want to guess? The United States. The United States was the first country to celebrate Mother's Day. Okay, here's another one. Which of the following flowers is associated with Mother's Day? Is it daisies, lilies, or carnations?
Lily of the Valley.
Lily of the Valley is the flower for the month of May. That's right. For Mother's Day, usually we think of carnations. Everybody gets carnations for Mother's Day. Okay, how about this? Which month is Mother's Day celebrated in? Is it April, May, or June? May, this month, that's right. We're celebrating this month, Mother's Day. Now, in the Roman Catholic Church, who is most associated with Mother's Day? Is it the Virgin Mary, Mary Magdalene, or Eve? Which woman? Mary, the mother of Jesus, Mary Magdalene, or Eve? It is Mary, the mother of Jesus. She is most associated with Mother's Day. What is the most popular gift purchased for Mother's Day? Is it flowers? Is it cards? Or is it balloons? Who wants to guess? What is the most purchased gift for Mother's Day? Flowers. That's a good guess. Flowers and cards. Cards are the most purchased gift at Mother's Day. Alrighty, how about this? I'm going to give you a saying, and I want you to tell me if you can fill in the blank. So the saying is, blank is the mother of invention. Is it money is the mother of invention? Patience is the mother of invention? Or necessity is the mother of invention? Who remembers what the word is? Necessity is the mother of invention. Very good. Very good, sir. Very good. Okay. There are two princes in England, Prince William and Prince Henry. Harry. Who was their mom? Was it Queen Elizabeth, Princess Diana, or Princess Kate? Who's the mom for William and Harry? Diana. Princess Diana. Very good. That's right. Now, you beat me to the next one. Who is Prince Charles's mom? Queen Elizabeth. That's right. Very good. You all did a good job with that. You know quite a bit about Mother's Day. Well, I want to read you a story about a lady, and her name is Emma. And Emma woke up one Monday morning, just like today. She woke up one Monday morning in May. And I want to tell you a story about what she did that Monday morning. The name of Emma's story is What the Wind Showed Emma. When Emma woke up, the first thing she thought about was, she wanted some breakfast. She was hungry, and she was ready to eat some bacon and eggs. The second thing she thought about was the weather. Would it be rainy and cold, or sunny and warm? She got dressed and had her breakfast and was ready to see what Mother Nature had in store for her on this beautiful May morning. She peeked out the window and decided to face the day head on. When she stepped outside, she smiled. There would be sunshine today. A few white, puffy clouds slowly edged their way across the sky. The early morning sunlight appeared welcoming. The early spring air felt crisp and clean, and it was just cool enough that taking in a deep breath, oh, that felt so good. It was very windy, and the air felt fresh against Emma's face. She enjoyed hearing the cool breezes whip over the branches and leaves of the trees, and suddenly, something caught Emma's attention. A beautiful white and gray feather. I'm going to put that right up there. She stood in amazement at how the wind gracefully kept this feather in the air and slowly moved it along. Well, then it settled itself on a vibrant pink rose. I'm going to put that picture right up there. Researchers have found that the sight of flowers can elevate a person's mood. Just seeing a flower is said to make a person feel better, feel cheerful. She bent down, and the scent was like a delicate perfume. Flowers are nature's way of making a person smile and feel loved. Beautiful flowers like this pink rose are present in nature all over the world. And they belong to all of us. Well, where would the breeze take the little feather next? The wind carried the feather down to the ground, and Emma leaned over near the feather and spotted a ladybug. There are over 5,000 varieties of ladybugs. They have little black spots. Some have as many as 2 dots, and some have up to 15 black dots. But this one had the normal 7 perfect black dots. Ladybugs are known to be a sign of good luck. carried by the breeze, the feather floated haphazardly, first this way and that way, and it finally fluttered down on a bench. So Emma sat down too. She heard a fluttering of wings and a stunning bird gracefully landed on a branch right across from where Emma sat. Oh, this little creature was chubby. It was a red pole bird. That's the name of this little bird, red pole. It's an amazing songbird that usually travels with a bunch of other birds. They're known for their unique coloring. They have a bright red patch on their forehead, and he just sat there staring at Emma. These birds are known to have an energetic zapping call that sounds like this. Dree, dree, dree. Have any of you all ever seen this kind of a bird? A red pole bird? I never had. Well, the little red pole lifted up his wings and soared away into the treetops. Emma stayed on the bench, looking down at the feather that had started her on this little journey. It sat curled a bit, as if waiting to take off once again with the next gust of wind. She thought about how there is beauty all around us, isn't there? We just need to stop and take a look. And as if right on cue, a huge gust of wind lifted that feather right off the bench, up, up, away into the sky. That feather flew. She watched it as it became smaller and smaller as it drifted out of view. She might never see that feather again. But from now on, Emma would take time every day to look around and admire all that nature has to offer us, especially in the month of May and the season of spring. Isn't that a good idea? I really appreciated this story, and I appreciated what Emma had to say, because sometimes I'm just walking along, looking, not paying a bit of attention to all that nature has to offer us. So I thought that was a good story and a good reminder. Well, I've got another poem for us, and this one is called Mellow May. Mellow, mild May day, calling children out to play. Summer's on her way, butterflies in trees, brilliant sunsets, starry eves. Time for ice cream, please. Miss Lori, are we going to have some ice cream today?
Definitely.
Oh, I know. Everybody here has ice cream on Monday, don't you? Well, you know, we've talked a little bit about flowers and how we think of flowers starting to bloom and blossom, how we plant flowers in the season of spring. And here we are on a Monday afternoon, certainly in the season of spring in the month of May. So I brought a book with me today, a big book that I thought you all might enjoy. It's one of my favorites, and it's called Planting a Rainbow, and it's all about planting flowers. So I wanted us to read that together today. We sow the seeds and set out the plants in soil. Can everybody see it if I put it right here, or should I hold it up? Can you all see it? And we watch the rainbow grow. Oh, the beautiful colors that we have of flowers. Ha! And the flowers grow and grow. We've got orange and red and blue and purple. Okay, now here comes my favorite part of the book. We have some red flowers, like tulips and carnations and roses. We have some orange flowers, like zinnias and poppies and tiger lilies. We have some yellow blooms, like daisies and daffodils. Now, we grow some green, like ferns. My favorite color, and some blue flowers, morning glories, delphinium, hyacinths, and cornflowers. And some purple flowers too, crocus, phlox, violets and iris, asters and pansies. All spring and summer long, we pick the rainbow of flowers and bring them home. Isn't that a beautiful bouquet of pretty rainbow flowers? I like this book. Because flowers, I always think about flowers during the month of May and the season of spring. You know, we just read that seeing a flower is said to increase happiness levels. Now, what do you all think? When you see a flower, when you smell a sweet flower, doesn't that just make you feel better? Yeah, it makes me smile, and that's what we say. Flowers are nature's way of making a person smile and feel loved. Let's think about that for just a minute. I want to show you some pictures and see if you can help me remember some things. This is a picture of a bridal bouquet. It's a picture of a bride holding her bouquet. Do any of you all remember your bouquet? Your wedding day bridal bouquet? Does anybody remember the flowers you had in your bouquet? Maybe some roses, some daisies maybe, some white flowers, or maybe colored flowers. Okay, here's another one. How about corsages? Can you all see the picture of the corsages on the girl's wrist? Did anybody remember getting a corsage? Maybe for a dance? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Or a special occasion? Or how about gentlemen, a boutonniere? Anybody remember getting a boutonniere maybe on your wedding day? Or for a school dance? Alright, well, I've got some pictures of other flowers. Anybody like lilac? This is a picture of beautiful purple lilac bush.
They smell so good,
don't they, Lori? How about sunflower seeds? Sunflowers. Sunflowers follow the sunshine. So as the sun moves during the day, so do the sunflowers. This is a hibiscus. Anybody ever grow any hibiscus? Anybody ever have a flower garden at your house? Yes. How about a water lily? Oh, I love water lilies. How about a water lily? How about a creeping phlox? This is a picture of a creeping phlox that grows on the ground. And one of my favorite flowers is a black-eyed Susan. I love black-eyed Susans that are kind of like a daisy. And then I've got a picture of a daisy. Daisies. Anybody ever grow any daisies? Or daisies may be your favorite flower? Well, my last flower picture, who knows what these are? Tulips, that's right. Tulips are beautiful spring flowers. Now, I've got something fun for us to do. I hope you're going to think it's fun. I've got a song. You all know that I like to bring music when I come. Well, I've got a song that was made famous by these three sisters right here. They're the McGuire sisters. Anybody remember the McGuire sisters? Christine, Dorothy, and Phyllis.
They were born in Ohio, and they were very popular between 1952 and 1968, and they sounded kind of like the Andrews Sisters. Do you all remember them? Well, a couple of their famous songs were Sugar Time and Sincerely, and they all dressed alike, and they moved together to the music. I want to play a song for you and see if you can recognize it. I hope I'm going to get this going. All right, let's see here if we can get this song going. I want to see if you recognize it. It's about flowers.
Tiptoe to the window. By the window, that is where I'll be. Come tiptoe through the tulips with me.
You remember it?
Come on, honey, and tiptoe from your pillow to the shadow of a willow tree. And tiptoe through the tulips with me.
Do you all remember that song? Yes, that's a very fun song, isn't it? And the McGuire sisters made that famous. I thought that was kind of fun for us thinking about flowers today.
And then Tiny Tim.
Oh, Lori. Tiny Tim. Any of you all remember Tiny Tim singing that song? Well, that's where I first heard it, was Tiny Tim, but I just don't like his voice as much as I like the McGuire sisters. So I thought we'd listen to the McGuires. Well, it has been so good to be here with you all today. I have appreciated you letting me come by and us talk on this Monday afternoon about the month of May, the fifth month that we're in, and the season of spring. You know, we talked about different things that go on during the month of May, and one that I mentioned was Memorial Day. Well, when we think about Memorial Day, I think of a very important place in the United States that we celebrate Memorial Day, and that is Arlington National Cemetery, where heroes rest. Have any of you all ever been to Arlington Cemetery? Oh my goodness, yes. It is the most important burial ground in the country, and at least one person from each American war or conflict is buried there. The land on which the cemetery is located is in Arlington, Virginia, and it lies just right across the Potomac, right across from Washington, D.C. Tourists visit that cemetery. Millions and millions of tourists visit there every year. They tour the grounds, they visit the monuments and memorials, and they remember the many people who have helped to make America the great country it is today. This is a picture of some of the graves, of some of the tombstones. Now, this is a picture of the amphitheater. Because Arlington National Cemetery honors the patriots who served our country, it's very special, and it attracts a lot of visitors. Large crowds come to Arlington, especially on Memorial Day and the 4th of July. And so when they do come, they always meet here in this amphitheater. It was built especially for important programs that they have at the cemetery. Now, I bet you're going to recognize this. This is a very important, special monument at the cemetery. It is the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. Mm-hmm. Originally, this tomb held the body of an unknown soldier from World War I. He was laid there to rest in front of the amphitheater on Armistice Day in 1921. And then in 1937, the tomb was placed under 24-hour guard. There is at least one soldier there all the time, guarding the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. Three additional unknowns were buried there: World War II, Korea, and Vietnam Wars. And here's what it says on the tomb. Here rests in honored glory an American soldier known but to God. I like that, and I think it's very important, don't you all, that we remember our veterans. Mm-hmm. This is the last picture I've got of the cemetery. The most impressive sight at Arlington is the rows and rows of white gravestones that just seem to go on forever, don't they? There are over 400,000 Americans, soldiers, important citizens, and even presidents that are buried there today. And about 15 to 20 people are buried every day at Arlington National Cemetery. I thought that it was important for us during this month of May, when we get ready to think about Memorial Day, I thought it was important for us to remember Arlington Cemetery. Thank you all. Thank you so much for letting me come today. I love to come to GG and visit all of you all. So, if it's okay with Lori, I'll be back again next month.
Definitely.
Come back for the month of June, and we will talk again about everything that's going on.